Hello, my friends. I'm G Hondo, and welcome back to our Let's Play of Darkest Dungeon. So for today's expedition, I've chosen this mission here for one simple reason. I have two lepers. One has this object, and one does not. So we're going to go and get another one so that they both can have one, because it is a pretty good item. Basically just a straight and pretty substantial bonus to accuracy. A little bit of extra critical hit chance. Not a huge deal, but fine, and all it takes is a little bit of extra stress, and the leper can de-stress himself, so it's really not a big deal. Other than that, just took a grave robber for some extra ranged power, and the arbalest who basically will be doing healing, so hopefully I don't get too stressed. But let's go. Food, light, probably don't really need that much. It's only a medium. Key, shovel, and I guess that's all I'm taking because I'm pretty much broke. Awesome. So I guess we'll have to go with the lightly provisioned version. Should probably just make this an actual cash run at some point. But anyway.
The smell of rotting fish is almost unbearable.
Officially, we are doing a 90% explore, and unfortunately, this place is laid out poorly, so we're gonna have to do a lot of backtracking, but that's fine. Let's just get it going. I could use a shovel here, but I'm gonna save the shovel. These have a good chance of being positive anyway. And this is why we should have shovels.
Another misfortune.
Relief, I'm pretty sure you do. You're better off using nothing on this one. Well, it's not a super powerful ability, but it's positive, so why not? Traps shall be done by you, clearly. What with that 110% and all? Very excellent scouting. I'm assuming that's you doing it, but I don't know. Either way. Right, go away. It's a pretty good start, I must say. Shovel, but we'll just use that one as is.
Awarded to the brave and the cool.
With this much scouting, I'd like to think if there is a secret room in here, we're going to find it. Which in the way, curious. See if we can do a similar round to last time. Nope, not quite. Not quite as good. Definitely not as good.
Their formation is broken. Maintain the offensive.
Ow. That was modestly impolite. So not too much worse than last time. I'll get an extra key. That's helpful.
Remind yourself that overconfidence is a slow and insidious killer.
Yeah, I'm gonna run out of light. With all the backtracking I'm gonna have to do in this one, I'm going to be running out of light. Let's do the short backtrack first. So that pretty much mapped out everything. Just about. But you still have to officially explore it, even with a map. Right, you are a problem. Stressor problem sorted. Hue here is good because it attacks both, so the protection, like the protection part, like the 25 protection still works, but the guarding part does not. That's one good thing about him choosing the guy right in front of him. I can heal them both. If he had chosen this guy, it would have been a much bigger problem. But he's no longer a choice. You seem to be missing a lot. Do you have a penalty to... No, you don't. You just lack the bonus that this one has. And this is why I wanted another one of these. That accuracy is very, very helpful. Shame we couldn't pass it back and forth in the middle of battle, but...
For decisive pummeling.
Very nice. I do have a bandage. I think I'd rather save it for a curio. I can't remember if there's... Bandage ones in here or not, though.
As victories mount, so too will
resistance. And I can't easily check my notes because I have to play this in full screen because OBS is being very, very finicky about it. And for some reason, it's only recording about two-thirds of the screen. I'm putting a humongous black bar around the rest. And even when I just got fed up and switched back to the old version, that one just went complete black screen. There was zero video at all, so... I don't know what has changed about this game, but it clearly does not get along with OBS very well.
Finding the stuff is good. Only the first test. Now it must be carried home.
That on the screen for a second. If you'd like to read, go ahead and pause. Even though I'm fairly sure we've seen all of them by now. We're not getting the scouting that we got at the beginning. It's not cool.
Otherworldly corruption.
Incredibly inconvenient, I must say. So I have no way of shooting both of those at the same time. guess we'll just work on somebody else. So annoying, he's one hit. I can't touch him because of this idiot. So annoying. And this idiot gets that huge protection bonus on top of what he already has, so. Very annoying. He was supposed to kill him and get rid of the corpse, but it only did one. Protection has run out. Giant oyster.
Trick of the light.
No, I can use. I know I could use dog treats to feed it, or a shovel to pry it open. But I don't have either of those. I don't think you get anything. Yeah, it's almost always empty if you just do it without. Alright, now we wander all the way back. And hope we have enough torches to do so. At least when you're going over explored ground, it doesn't take up the torches fast. Well, it takes up 1 point per square instead of the 6, I think it is, that it normally takes when you're exploring. Master plan is to camp in the room here, because when camping's done, you get full torch back. So I'm kind of going to A, get the health back, and B, cheat myself up some extra torch light by doing that. Still got tons of food, that's fine.
The battle may yet be won.
Does anyone know how to block nighttime attacks? Probably not. So we may very well get a nighttime attack. But so be it. Jumped, we'll have to do a zero torch fight, but we didn't, so we get full torch back.
Spirits are lifted.
Excellent.
And purpose is made clear.
We should probably only have to go to this room here, or maybe this one, but I think it's going to end here. Oh, wait, clearly. Oh, it's only the shovel on this one. I got that mixed up. That was a waste of a key. Goodbye, little irritant. Fairly impolite.
Be gone, fiend.
I can be impolite too.
Executed with impunity.
Oh, good, an extra torch. Very nice. Stressors. Get rid of this one first, just because this one has a stress wave that can affect two people, whereas this one can only affect one. I don't care if this thing does its eldritch push or pulls, those things don't bother me. But this thing's double stress wave and the ability to juice up other ones is much, much more annoying. Kaboom. I forgot that this one's stress wave also dims the torch, that one's doesn't, but that's okay. We'll just do that and forget about it. Lots of stuff.
This expedition at least promises success.
We might as well use the key now.
Packs laden with loot are often
low. Guess we're just
supplies.
About done. Riggins. How quaint. Excellent. One hit point left. Who else wants to place bets my next hit on him's critical?
Prodigious size alone does not
very surprising.
The sharpened blade. And improvement.
Okay. Congratulations, have a bandage. Oh no, we'll be making room for that. Great. Have a holy water. So one hole is left. A couple of curios we can go and grab. Oh, how convenient. Eerie coral. Pretty sure that one wants holy water. And it's pretty bad if you don't have it, so we're gonna skip that one. The enormous whale. No, I'm not going to do that one. I am actually going to walk towards the trap, simply because at 110%, he's not going to fail, and that will knock some stress off, meaning his next adventure, he'll start off, you know, that little bit less. And that will do it.
Despite its morbid aspect, This twisted, cavernous maze seems almost traversable.
So we did pretty well here. Those gems helped a lot. Didn't do so well on this stuff, but we got the thing we came for, and that's cool. Fascinating. Terrible. And convenient, but not a big deal. It's bad, but it's temporary. And that's convenient, so that one's really the only one that really bothers me. The obsession ones kind of are a problem too sometimes, but that one seems pretty rare, so.
The plume and the pistol. A fitting end to my folly, and a curse upon us all.
So let's go ahead and get you that. Clean up there. And let's take a super quick look, see if there's anything here. Do I need another leper? No. Do I need an occultist? I don't think I have one. I do not. Welcome aboard.
To fight the abyss, one must know it.
Oh good, you're afraid of the stuff you're the best at. You know, a lot of your stuff has bonuses against Eldritch, so that's really helpful. That's not such a big deal unless I give you this ability, which I might. And that's just most convenient. Okay, go with that. So I'll have to sort your skills out. I'll do that off camera. And yeah, so we'll call that a good place to end for this episode. So thank you everyone for watching today. Until next time, folks, stay calm, and I hope you come and chill with me again in the next video. Thanks for watching. Bye now.